I feel like this is gonna turn into a thing where it's like, Amish is really rich. Okay.
Hey, what's up, YouTube? This is Alexander Grace with Red Pill Interviews. I'm here at the University of Western Australia, and today I'm gonna be conducting a little bit of an experiment. I've created a dating profile for a guy, and I'm gonna get girls to scroll through and tell me what they think. Let's take a look. So, as you can see, he's just a regular looking dude, perhaps like a little bit nerdy, and I've created some characteristics about him that sort of reinforce that image. You know, he's a virgin, he's into computer games, but he's also very, very successful, you know, very wealthy, ambitious, you know, has a lot of high status. So according to the Red Pill community, you know, women are hypergamous, they're really into status. So what we're going to find out is if women are willing to overlook some of the nerdier aspects of this guy and go on a date with him, you know, and have a relationship with him just because he's, you know, really wealthy and ambitious and all that good stuff. So are they going to want to date this guy? I'm not sure, but that's what we're going to find out.
Oh, well, he looks very smart because the glasses.
Yeah, the glasses do make me think that he's smart. He looks quite nice, like I like that he's smiling.
And he's smiling
in the photo.
Yeah. I think it's definitely good that he's smiling.
Yeah.
He's alright. Yeah, he's a strong 6 or 7.
I really like the photo. It's got the brightness, so I can actually see his face clearly.
Yeah, but he looks friendly as well. He's got the friendly face, like a bit of a beard. It makes him look quite casual, which is nice.
Yeah. Yeah, so far, pretty keen. Not bad.
Yeah, it's pretty
I'd say he looks very intelligent. The glasses, they make him like he's an intelligent guy.
Yeah. Would I date him?
Not per se my type personally, but you know, I'm sure there's a lot of lovely ladies out here that would be interested.
29 years old.
See, that's a bit old.
10 years.
He's 29. Okay, that's a bit old. But he looks young.
Yeah, I feel like if I met him in real life, I would be a bit more, like, wouldn't worry so much about the age.
I would definitely talk to him. Like, he looks approachable.
Okay, 29, virgin. personally, it's not really my thing.
Yeah. I think, the virgin thing definitely makes a difference.
29, I don't know, you know, I'm sure someone would be into it, you know, especially, I don't know, if you're waiting for marriage or something.
He's a virgin, if that makes any difference. I do not mind.
It's not unattractive, but it's just weird that he felt the need to mention it.
Yeah, I feel like it's not an important thing, but if you mention it, then it's going to be a weird thing. Like, I feel like you just shouldn't mention it.
It's so irrelevant.
You're like, you know what I mean? With that person.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Oh, he's a virgin. Oh, that's sad. I mean... I mean, it's not a problem. I mean, it is a bitch. I don't know.
Enjoys computer games. Oh, that's cute.
Yeah, I like that. Bird watching is interesting.
Yeah, I like that. It's cute.
It's quirky. Yeah.
The bird watching's cool.
Yeah. It's different.
Like, computer games are not so into them.
Yeah. I don't really want a boyfriend that likes computer games, but I understand
it takes up too much time.
Yeah, any more time for me?
Well, that's why he's a virgin, because he enjoys computer games and bird watching.
I mean, it's not attractive. I mean, I don't really have any preferences of anything, really, so that's pretty cool. I love computer games myself, so, yeah. Has a master's in engineering, he's smart, that's cool.
Yeah, that's cool.
Yeah, that's...
I enjoy a smart...
Yeah, engineering is...
Yeah. Okay, which is like, it's all coming together now. engineers are boring though.
Yeah, see, that's more attractive.
Yeah, definitely.
Because he's accomplished in his life and, like, you know, he could have a well-earning job.
He started his career as a tech consultant for major companies like Google and Apple. Impressive. It's very good.
So he's rich. That's good. Oh, I'm so shallow. But that's okay.
That
also makes him very attractive. To be honest, he looks like the type of guy that would have that going for him.
Oh. That's interesting. Because major companies like Google and Apple, like, he's obviously earning a lot of money.
Yeah, he's obviously probably, like, quite approachable as well. Like, to get a job like that, you would have to be quite a friendly person.
Yeah, and good at what he does as well.
Just good to know that someone's, like, intelligent and can have good conversation with them.
It's and has, like, goals. Like, he obviously
is hardworking and motivated and stuff like that, you know.
It would be not ideal to date someone that was just, like, a slob and wasn't really, didn't have any passion, I guess.
this guy knows what he's doing with his life.
Yeah.
For sure. So that's attractive.
Oh, okay. Now he runs his own software company with over 200 employees. So, yeah, he's definitely rich.
That's crazy. I would never be able to do that.
Well, there you go, Christopher. He's got his shit together.
Isn't he just so successful at age 29?
This is getting kind of intimidating.
Yeah,
now.
Exactly.
I kind of feel a bit intimidated.
200 employees is obviously very, got a lot of leadership qualities, which I don't...
Yeah.
Like, that's attractive, I guess, but still.
He owns houses in Sydney, San Francisco, and Singapore. Nice. That's crazy.
Okay, I would go there. So, this is... Yeah.
Yeah, I don't think the owns houses thing really makes a difference.
Yeah,
like, I think just like mainly his intelligence, that's like a good thing. Like, you know.
So he's rich and
that's pretty cool.
Yeah. Oh, well, like, are they investment houses or are they like holiday houses?
I don't know.
So that'd be cool because if you dated him, you could go to Sydney, San Francisco and Singapore.
And he's worth over $65 million. You know, like, that's intense.
Yeah. Yeah. Oh, yeah, he's rich. No crap.
You know, good for him. I mean, it's always great to hear, I guess. Nice to be with someone who's financially stable, obviously.
What? He's 29, he does all of that. That's intense. Well,
yeah.
So on the balance, would you date him? Like, if he asked you out, would you go on a date?
I think I would get to know him.
I think he would be more like a friend first, and then we'd start dating because I'd, you know, find out all his cool little quirks and stuff.
But, like, on initial attraction, if I knew nothing about him, I'd probably just, like, all, like...
I didn't know him, though.
Yeah. You know.
I'm definitely really interested to get to know him. He's got a lot of scholarly advice he could possibly give to me.
But still, maybe. I don't know. It depends what his personality is like.
Yeah. If I was 29, maybe.
Yeah.
Yeah. I don't know if the things that he listed makes him more attractive, though.
Yeah, no. I'm not sure about that, because it's just so much.
Yeah.
Yeah, that seems like a... Like, obviously, you know, I think you always just have to get to know someone's personality. So,
yeah.
You know, that's important. So.
Yeah, a bit of a workaholic.
Yeah,
actually. With all those achievements, like, where does he have time for social life?
Yeah.
And dating. Probably wouldn't have time to go on a date with me.
And yeah, and it's only like the face. There's more to see if you get me.
I don't know. I just like, he's not like particularly my type. Like, that's all. Like, it's nothing rude or anything. Like, he's a good looking guy. He's just like not necessarily what I would immediately go for. So, yeah.
I agree with that statement. I literally agree with everything she said.
Yeah. But obviously, like, when you get to know someone, things change. So, yeah.
But if he did ask you on a date, would you say yes?
I'd go on a date. Like,
if I didn't have a boyfriend yet. Like,
well, you're not going to be poor. You can be, they can be your sugar daddy. And he's only 29, so, like, that will work. And he's a virgin, so he's easily manipulated. So, like, not, well, he is.
Hey, guys, thanks for watching. Be sure to like and subscribe and leave a comment below letting us know what you thought of the girls' responses in the video. As always, if you want to show your support for Red Pill Interviews, the best way to do that is to check out my Patreon page. That's where you can see uncut footage from all of my interviews. Thanks for watching, and I'll catch you next time.